Lunar Night. Lunar Night. Let's
go. Thank you.
And the land is done. And the moon.
I want to first off say thank you for everybody who's come. Not a big crowd, but it doesn't mean, it means a lot that the fact that you did come. It means a lot that the people did come tonight, so I appreciate you, a pat on your back for coming. Thank you very much.
Yay!
Be afraid, just as long.
People are funny, but, you know, true friends come out. You come out to the one's birthday party, and you would come out to one's funeral. So I see you all out here, so if anything was to happen to me, or God forbid, then I see this is people who are coming to my funeral. So that's nice.
By me.
Reflect back on when I was a kid, and my father told me, boy! Hey, boy! Never call me George.
And in the sky,
they said, damn it, what are you doing now? And I told him, well, I said, you know, I'm on the telephone right now. I got it. Let me finish it. Get off that telephone!
And the mountain.
And then, of course, my aunt would come every Thanksgiving and said, you're not going to mountain down. What are you going to do with that crazy TV show?
No, I won't be afraid.
I am a person that is very straightforward, I believe, in being who I am. I don't change like the wind. I say something, pretty much I believe in it. I respect other people's beliefs, but I am very opinionated. I guess I'm an egotistical, opinionated bastard, but it doesn't really matter.
When you're mean, won't you stand by me?
Narcissistic way that I'm narcissistic. I love myself. Damn, believe I do. I am confident about myself. What I do on TV and what I do in my real world is partially who I am. Yes, I'm confident. I love myself. If that makes me narcissistic in your eyes, then so be it.
Won't you stand by me? And if you're in need, won't you stand by me?
If I take something by the horns, and I take something and I do something, I believe in doing it right. I don't believe doing something half-assed. I do my best. I try to make the people who watch me on TV laugh. As Jimmy Buffett would so once said, if we couldn't laugh, we all would go insane. Yep. And I believe that laughter is the best medicine for all. And I plan to continue entertaining the masses out there, love me or hate me, like me, whatever. Controversy is the name of the game, and we get your attention. That's the main thing. So I do appreciate everybody coming tonight. I didn't come with a script, but I'm glad you're here. And let's get into some more karaoke tunes. Thanks very much, and God bless everybody.
That's my best side there.
Okay, there you go. Baby! What is causing all this? My camera needs to be raised up a little bit. Anyway,
we'll fix it up, baby. I'll fix it.
All right, so now we're talking to you all. We're talking to you ladies out there. Where have you been? You haven't had the opportunity to see Gorgeous George in the raw, baby. Woo! Every girl's fantasy is to see Gorgeous George, baby, in the raw. We play a rotational schedule with the station, so all you people deprived might not see the full effect, the Rexon effect, because all I want to do is with my zoom zoom and your boom boom and shake that rump. No, but see, because we get on here and we try to do a public service announcement. to all you fans out there that worship us and worship us and just want to bow down to me. You know, good God. I mean, I think I'm the next coming of Christ, but you know.
What can I
say? Next coming of Christ, next coming of the Mac Daddy. And then we got Vanilla Ice and, what's up, Wills? Todd Bridges.
Yeah.
Now, I thought Todd Bridges DO'd or died on the
road. No.
And take Danny Bruccio on the Partridge Family over Bobby Blair of the Brady Bunch.
Bobby, yeah, I know.
He's older than he's older. There's a family. Their name is Brady. Let me sing a song. Do it to me one more time. You know once is never enough, like a stud like me. Oh yeah, let me do it to you one more time. Play the piano. Once is never enough, like a stud like me. Boo! All right, we got Rob on.
Hi.
Talk to us.
Hello?
Hello.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing. How you doing?
Hey, really quick question for you.
Talk.
I saw you at a concert the other day. I was like, I saw you eating right there. I was going to say hi to you and see what was up, but you were stuck in your fat face.
Daniel?
Hey, George.
Hi, this is Daniel Fur.
It's great to have you back on the air. I wanted to ask you about George Bush. It's really great to have you back on the air.
Okay.
And I see you haven't taken a bath since.
All right, Daniel Freer, you will not.
Since with your mom.
You will not, yeah. I was bathing. I was bathing your mom, and I was doing a bristle rub on her area down there, and she said, "Ooh!" And obviously, she has venereal disease. Thank you very much, Mr. Freer. You will not come back on. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, line two, half-heartedly. Okay, I take the crap out of your mouth before you call next time. Okay, J.G. Chaplin, you know, and I know who that is. We've got a phone call. We got a phone call from Gretchen. Gretchen, line one, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Fuck you, George.
Okay, well, was that Gretchen or was that some homosexual calling up here? Thank you very much. It's line one, but we have no, that worries me. Okay, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Crazy pig.
What's that?
You're a creep.
Okay, well, you take it up the butt from your daddy. Thank you very much. That caller was blocked, so. Brandon, you're on the air with us. Okay, you need to go down with that because you're never coming back on, buddy. Talk to us. Okay. There, line two, you're on the air. Talk to us. Okay, I'm. Brandon, line two, you're on the air. Talk to us. Comments or questions for our show tonight? Okay. I'm not a homophobic, but I will say that you know, the guy sounded gay to me. And if you take offense to that, then I'm sorry.
Well, you look bad.
Okay.
29-year-old.
On the air, Diane, talk to us. Hello.
Hi, this is Diane. I wanted to make a comment to you about Enrico Doctor's Hospital.
Go right ahead.
Oh God.
Okay, what's your comment or question? Because my hand's right on the presser here.
Well, I'm not going to say anything rude. That's it.
Oh, gosh.
George. I'm Rick from Richmond.
Okay, what's your comment or question?
I'm just really happy that you're back and that you're back on the air. And I think it's a great benefit to Richmond and television in general that you return. And I think the Media One should let you on all the time. You fat tit.
Compared to a thin pig?
Do you have a fat fetish? Obviously, you like your women fat, don't you? You like your women very thick and juicy, don't you, and fat?
Yeah,
how
you doing?
How's it going?
I
just want to ask, how much do you pay your model to be there for that fat look?
On the air. Okay. Richard, on line one or line two?
Line one.
Talk to us, Richard.
You're fat.
Thank you.
Your mama is. Thank you very much. And you know what? You had sex with your granny the other day, and she was very prudicious. Thank you very much. Okay, Rachel, line two.
All right.
Talk to us.
Hi.
Hi.
I have a comment about Enrico County.
Go ahead.
All right.
Okay. Is that enough for you? It's good enough for me. On the air.
Hey, take a bath, you fat.
Okay. Line one.
Hi.
Lou.
Any other comments? You need a bass.
I need nothing from you, okay? If I want a comment from you, I'll be calling you on your show, okay? You call me on my show. I don't need nothing, no comments from the peanut gallery. How you doing?
Hey, what do you think about Jimmy Williams' situation?
Jimmy Williams, enlighten me.
He got fired.
He got fired?
Yeah, you didn't hear about that?
I didn't hear a word about that. Who is Jimmy Williams?
You're a fat dude.
All right.
And you suck and swallow. Thank you very much. Hello?
Hi, we barely hear you out here.
You can barely hear me?
Yeah, you can turn your mic up.
Okay, well, the mic is up. Can you hear me?
That's fucking...
Okay. All right. You don't even need a microphone.
Swallow. Thank you very much. You on there,
yeah.
When you talk to
or people who do good for other people.
Okay. you're on the air.
Jimi Hendrix.
Okay, up your ass. Thank you. Why don't you talk to us?
I'm taking a pot shot of you, George.
You're taking a pot shot of me? But I'm a black. Thank you very much. There you go. Line one. Up your ass. Thank you. Line one. Talk to us. With a rubber hose.
Take a flying leap.
Line two. Talk to us.
Oh, man.
Line one, talk to us. Line two, talk to us. Jingle bells. Talk to us.
It's like...
I don't think so. You keep calling up here too much. Line one, talk to us.
What is wrong with you?
Okay, what's wrong? All right, time out, Jordan. Time out.
Yeah. Did you know that?
Line one, talk to us. You're on the air.
Shitbag.
Okay, line two, talk to us. You bag it? Line two.
Hey. I think you guys like blood sex.
Okay, I think that you take it up the mouth, basically, of the mouth. Line one, talk to us.
Hey, how you doing? I'm sorry about all these calls, these kids calling up, you know, via punks and stuff.
Right.
I wanted to talk to you a little bit about, you know, the idols you're talking about.
Right.
That's the issue with Eric Clapton, because he's not a fat. Why?
Talk to us, we'll yell at you.
You're on the air. Okay, line one, talk to us. Okay, line two, talk to us. Okay, line one,
talk to us. Now, what's going on here?
Okay, I keep doing this over and over again because you know what? I mean, hey, it's what it boils down to. You on the air? Talk to us. You on the air?
Hey, fat.
Okay, you got a fat fish? Merry Christmas. You on the air? Talk to us.
Hey, we met Brown Brown a couple weeks ago.
Did we?
Hey!
How you doing?
Hey, I was wearing a brown shirt on tennis ball.
I got you.
Talked a little while.
Okay, great. And I give you a pamphlet.
You think like shit.
No.
You know what? You eat shit. Thank you.
Oh, man.
Line one. Line one.
Hey, this last show sucks, man.
Okay, you swallowed. Thank you very much.
And I hate to tell you guys out there, but I am a heterosexual now, so I hate to burst your bubble. Okay.
Homo erectus.
No, well, anyway. There you go. But when it comes to united, we stand, united, we fall. And this is a tragedy. This is a tragedy. This is a major, major something that's unjust. And Osadam needs to pay the price. Better yet, why don't you swallow your own crap? Thank you very much. Swallow your mama's crap and her log, and maybe you might be able to speak better with a crap. You know, I guess that's the same equivalency what's coming out right now. Yeah. We are what's causing all this. We are the Cadillac of all calls and cars and shows and ensemble. Yeah. And I tell you what, it's a beautiful thing, ladies, when you see my picture on your TV screen. Yeah. It's a beautiful thing when you see Gigi popping through your underwear and blessing your TV screen, ladies.
Woo! You got that right.
Woo! Every Thursday night at 10:30, Gorgeous George blessing your picture tube and popping. Woo! Ladies, popping. Woo! Through your underwear.
We're talking about people such as Elvis Presley, yeah. Such as people that were icons, and to the gay community, Rock Hudson, of course.
You know, they're trying to...
It's Greg Brady.
Greg Brady. Well, yeah. You know, all I know, I mean, you had a Homo Brady who died, and then you had Florence...
Well,
and then you had Florence Nightingale. I mean, Florence... what's
Henderson.
Henderson.
Very good.
There you. Obviously, you're one of the people there that have no idea. I'm 200 pounds and probably can pound pounce you with one fliss. You consider yourself to be a nurse? Yeah, you must be a nurse because obviously you must be, nurse the gay people that come in there with syphilis and AIDS, probably. Okay,
nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that.
Okay, nah. The guy's probably a homo himself, basically.
Nothing wrong with that.
Okay, well, I'm calling a spade a spade here. Okay, don't correct me here.
Okay,
this is questions tonight.
What's going on here? No, I just want to see, why do they call you Gorgeous George?
Because one day I looked at myself in the mirror and I said, I'm gorgeous. Thank you very much. No, the guy sounded gay to me. And if you take offense to that, then I'm sorry.
Well, you look bad.
Okay, well, you look like you're not going to call back tonight, and you also look like that you probably need to play with your daddy a little bit, because obviously you have a trauma. You had a trauma as a little kid, and your daddy didn't give you a little something, and that's what you probably need to go back into to fill your securities. Thank you very much. So if you like it or don't like it, take a leading jump. Take a leading jump for your own fecal.
All the nurses gathered around to see the world. You see the Gorgeous George baby. Some got me confused with the Christ baby. But it doesn't matter the Christ baby or not, because it was the Gorgeous George baby. And all the nurses gather around and say, bad to the bone.
On the air. Okay. You know, that suppository that you took is not doing the job. So you need to take another one, prick. Yes. This is the Academy Award for the best. Phonogenetic. Oh, the best. Intelligent. Beautiful. Italian. God. Woo! Women worship me. Men respect me. Why is this camera moving back and forth? You need to go ahead. What you probably need to do is go ahead and get off that estrogen you're on and get it where you always know you can get it. By your man lover. Thank you very much, because your man lover can datify you and in places you never know. Okay? Get that garbage off my air. Line one.
I'm going to miss your bloated ass.
All right.
All righty.
She missed it last night, too.
Well, baby, you need a man in your life. That's your problem. You've been going from bar to bar trying to find Mr. Right, baby, but I'm here to tell you. And I'm only here to tell you, baby, that if you want excitement and if you want to hop on electricity, GG is the one to take care of you. We'll rub that Calamon oil on your buttocks. And we'll rub your buttocks smooth like sandpaper. And run it down to you. Well, roughly. And put it on your calves. And you have any bunions. Kevin, what do we do for bunions?
Bunions, we use hemorrhage.
I told you, man, we have special tools.
Oh, okay.
Tweezers.
All right.
We pop that bunion off.
I never. Oh. Okay. And we.
Line two.
Sad virgin.
Hey.
Alrighty. Sacrifice a virgin. Well, that's probably basically you're talking.
Where are you gonna find one in your house?
But actually the first time you probably had sex was with your mother. So don't talk to me. Basically, you probably had sex with your mother. For a testing guild.
Yeah.
No, we're not here about that.
Only because her grandmother was busy.
Maestro, any more?
So,
determined to get at least one legit call tonight. I'm determined to at least get one legit call.
Hello?
Hello.
Hello. You first.
Okay. Line two.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey.
Burgers.
Okay. Line two.
Homosexual.
Who are these folks?
What?
On the air.
Hey, how you doing?
How you doing?
Howdy.
Hey, what's up? I just wanted to ask you a little bit about Elvis. You talked about him earlier.
We're talking about the king.
Yes.
No, God.
You know, let's talk
sports.
You want me? Hello.
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 Hi. I just want to say, you know, it just doesn't seem to matter what topic you have each week. The same jerks just keep calling, and I'm really sorry about that. This is the low mentality.
God.
It's become a real.
Line one.
This has become the Howard Stern show all of a sudden.
Talk to me.
Stop stealing all the jackets from Century 21 agents.
Okay. Something in your mouth because you need to have your own feces.
This guy's fist.
You need to have your own feces in your mouth.
Oh, man.
And guess what? You swallow like a Tootsie Pop because you know what? Your mama should have taught you how to do that.
Oh, huh? How you doing?
Hi, you're a complete douche.
All right, yes.
If you're going to take pot shots at me, and if you're going to take all these shots, why don't you do it with a little bit of cleanliness? Clean the mouth a little bit. If you don't like me, and you don't want to have, you don't like my show and don't like me, if you want to give me a pot shot, it'll make you sound less of a jackass if you do it without using your vulgar tones. If you don't like my show and you want to heckle me, you think you're heckling me? Yeah, I mean, he heckles me a little bit because I am trying to do a production. Okay, so do whatever you want to do, but if you want to take a pot shot at me, you'll probably sound less of a jackass if you do it with no vulgar tones. Thank you very much. Mm. Well, too, you want me to...
You think like shit.
No.
You know what? You eat shit. Thank you very much.
Oh, man.
Censorship in any verbiage or any proximity of the word is a blatant crime. It was no more than a millisecond, or more like a millimeter of a second. You know, boom, or 10 seconds or whatever. If you don't want your kids to watch me and get an intellectual stimuli in their brain to watch intelligent thoughts that come out of my mouth, then you have a V-chip or you have a remote you can switch the freaking channel.
Yeah, turn the show off!
Drop
the stock!
There are worse things between a nipple that's under a pasty from Janet Jackson. I mean, come on now.
Well, the Columbine kids, what happened there, you know, the kids were not spanked. They were put in time out. They weren't disciplined. That's what happened.
And those kids were trained by video, excessive.
The mind coffee with yeah.
Excessive
Hitler,
video
yeah.
games.
Line one, talk to us. You're on the air. Huh? You know what? You need to take it up the rectum with a double dildo. Thank you very much. Line two, you're on the air. You fooky, fooky, fooky. You know what? Why don't you rub dogs with your daddy? Thank you. Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Hi, George.
Hello.
Hi. I wanted to ask you about your stretch in your hair.
Pardon me?
Your spot in your hair. I wanted to ask you about it.
That's an act from God, baby.
It looks pretty stupid.
Well, okay, line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
That girl was right.
Line one, talk to us, baby. Woo!
George, is tonight your last show?
No, it's not.
You're gay.
Well, you know what? You're gay and you're homosexual,
no,
and so is your pet gerbil.
No,
thank you very much.
George is...
Okay, you're homosexual, and we don't take calls from homosexuals. Thank you very much. Line two, talk to us.
Hey, George, can you crank call your home?
Okay, well, you know what? You can crank call your own home. Matter of fact, the faucet's running. You need to turn it off. Line one, talk to us. up yours. Thank you. You're on the air. Talk to us. Okay, you know what? I'm telling you, you need to gargle that out of your butt end because we can't hear you. The pump scum just called. You take it up the butt from your male lover. Thank you very much. Line one, talk to us. Woo!
Douchebag. I got a credit card story for you,
actually. Okay, let's hear it. Line one, talk to us. Woo!
Fat ass.
Okay, comments or questions tonight?
Dickhead.
Who?
George, how you shit at?
Okay. Comments or questions tonight?
Yeah, I was going to talk about gas bill, man. It really screwed me over. I mean, fat.
But see, you've got a fat fetish, and you've been rubbing dongs with your daddy. We don't want to hear this crap. Line two, you're on there. Talk to us.
Oh, yes. I'd like to say to the people that have been calling in and being rude, I myself am overweight. You're overweight. We can lose weight.
Okay, thank you very much for that call. You might be overweight, but I'm not overweight. I have no problem with my sexuality. I have no problem in the weight room. I have no problem running. I weigh 240 pounds. Yes, I do. I weigh 240 pounds, and I can run a marathon if I wanted to. A 2-mile. I'm working upon it. I run. I jog. I play racquetball. So I have no problem. Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
What's happening, George?
What's going on?
Nothing. I got a story. It's not about fraud. It's a bad experience I had at a store. See, I was paying your mom for sex.
Okay. Talk to us. Comments or questions?
Yeah.
Okay. Line one, you're on the air. Okay. Line one, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Morbidly obese.
You know what? Your mama is obese. As a matter of fact, when she went to the Sizzler, she had you. Thank you very much. When she went to the Sizzler, she had you, and they all came out late, and then they had to put you back in because you were stillborn. Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us. Goggle your own crap.
Hey,
line
George.
One, talk to us.
George.
Line one, talk to us.
Ah. That was the best caller yet.
Yeah.
He didn't bother us.
Excellent. I think one of you guys has it right tonight, the guy in the sweater. He's got it going on.
He's got it going on? Okay, well, I'm sure he likes to know that.
Thank you very much.
I think you and the pansy with the flower need to shove a can up your ass.
Hello?
Hello?
George.
Hey. Hey, I have a question about the Iraqi war.
Yeah, I got an answer for it.
Yeah, I wanted to see what you think. Do you think that maybe it would help if Bush got crystal meth for his girlfriend?
You're on the air with Gigi and Fritz.
I'm glad to see you back on the air, man. I missed your show.
Well, thank you very much. Who's your favorite band and music?
I really, really, really like, I think the SOS band. Remember that big disco band?
The SOS band.
Yeah, you don't remember
that? I remember that.
SOS band,
yeah.
Yeah, man, they had
a funny set. Okay, thank you.
Hey, George, you guys were talking about Maurice Gibb earlier from the Bee Gees.
Yes.
I heard that there was a thing on TV the other day about him, the show I was watching.
What were you watching?
It was like a biography about him. Apparently his girlfriend...
Okay, hello.
Hi, George, how are you?
I'm doing fine, how are you doing?
I'm great.
Great.
I have a question for you.
I got an answer for you.
How tall are you? Because you can't really tell with just sitting there. You look kind of tall.
I'm about 6'1".
No way.
Yes, boy.
I had no idea the steps shit that high.
Oh, boy.
Am I on there?
Yes. No!
Hey, the email address earlier, that's Fat Pig.
Boy. Line two, you're on the air.
Hello?
Okay, you're not checking on. Let's take one more call, and then we're going to put it to 99.
Yes.
Like,
maybe
this is why we put it to bed, basically.
Maybe it's for me.
Now, talk to us. Okay.
Again,
why don't you go on there and talk to us? Go on the air. Hello? Okay, you know what?
Because you've been gone.
Talk to us.
Hello?
Down.
Excuse me? Okay. Talk to us. That's what I said.
Yeah, that's it.
Okay. Comments or questions about what we had talked about, what we're talking about tonight?
Yeah, I got a comment. You're a fat.
Okay.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm doing fine. How you doing? Hello?
We prank call your cell phone.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, why don't you answer, Maury?
Well, line two. Talk to us. You're on the air.
Hi, George.
Hello.
How are you?
Comments or questions tonight?
Me a ring that I can have for crystal meth.
Okay. You got crap in your mouth and semen. Semen and crap at the same time. Why don't you crunch it down like some with Rice Krispies and some milk? Talk to me.
Yeah, like a football game you're talking about, Super Bowl.
Yeah.
I really like the Panthers because they got the best defense. You got.
Line two.
Yay.
Excuse me?
Yay.
I know what he did.
Yeah. Hello.
We ruin your show every week.
Yeah, I know you are. Goodbye. For ladies out there, let you all know that I wear briefs, and that's what it boils down to. So it's Haynes my way. I seem to have something on my forehead that says, if you have drama, if you have problems, if you're beautiful but you have problems, I want to date you. I have, because I do have good taste in women. I do have good taste in women. That's
well, from observation, I've seen that most marriages or relationships break up within 2 to 3 years, and it is about money.
Come down a little bit with you with Danny. We can come down.
Usually, it's about money in that time frame.
Well, we're not the Cleavers. Nobody's the Cleavers
right.
anymore. First of all, there is.
Living the Beaver. Now isn't Wally dead? Okay, I'm sorry. Remember Wally Beaver?
Yeah.
Isn't he dead? Whether it's a marriage, whether it's boyfriend, girlfriend, live-in, or whatever the classification is, no matter what the classification is, you got to have an equal balance, just like a pendulum. You got to, right there. Now,
then you regulate this, you regulate that, you regulate this. Why can't we regulate ourselves? Why just can't we all be like, okay, I'm a human
it's
being.
Easier.
I have this
that's
much
perfect role,
resolve and responsibility yeah. within my own mind, what my heart is doing.
Right.
Why can't but
that's
people
a perfect, that's a perfect role, and it'd be too easy. It'd be too easy to do a perfect role. But I mean, I think the courts really do really side with the woman because that's the woman had the child in her stomach. So yeah. And remember, I'm in charge of this ring circus. If you get nasty, if you get indignant. We're going to flush you down the commode with the diarrhea that's coming on our phones.
Throw the eggs in him.
Ew, ew.
All right.
Be nice, people, for Pete's sake.
Okay. Line one. You're on the air.
Man, lover.
Okay. Now, you see, there's a problem that we're having. You have a problem with yourself. So if you're going to call my program up and talk a bunch of crap like that, then you need to check yourself out and see what the problem is. Because obviously when you were a child, okay, there was a problem with your being. You didn't really know who you were.
Thank you, kid.
Until your daddy identified you in that little special place, so we know what I'm talking about. Thank you very much. Lion Sue, you're on the air. Talk to us, comments, and questions tonight.
Yeah, you guys are fucking morons.
Okay. See, you have a, you have a problem.
What's your name, first and last, first of all?
See, there's a suppository problem that you have because you can't poop. But we don't want to know about it. You need to take care of that problem. We don't need to hear about your suppository problem. Put it in there and poop, but don't poop on my show. Thank you.
Ew.
Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Hey, George, I got a relationship question for you.
Okay, keep it clean, please.
My girlfriend, a couple weeks ago, she started playing hard to get.
Yes, sir, really?
And recently, she just stopped responding to any of my calls.
Damn.
And I was wondering, did you eat her?
You know, once again, that's a personal problem that you need to take care of. But we don't want to hear about your personal problems about your daddy identifying you in certain places because we know the true story. Thank you very much. Line two, talk to us.
Yes, what about your personal problem with
smoking
penis?
Well, if you're into smoking your own penis, that's fine, but I don't want to hear about it. Thank you. Line one, talk to us.
Hi, George. How you doing?
Comments and questions tonight.
I just wanted to say happy birthday to you, yeah?
Thank you very much.
Hey, Dan, I also want to say that you're very fat.
Well, you know what? Baby, you're... Okay, thank you for telling me...
What did she say?
Thank you for wishing me happy birthday. And as far as me being fat,
damn,
I'm probably more man than you ever would have in your whole entire life. Matter of fact, you're probably fat, probably passing gas and eating the ice cream bars and watching my show.
Gee!
Okay? So you're sitting here and talking this crap on my show. I'm more man that's probably ever been in your whole entire existence. But the only difference is I'm on camera, so you haven't had a real man, baby. Passing gas, eating ice cream bars. Take care of that. Thank you. Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us. Now that diarrhea, you got a problem. You need to worry about the Imodium. Take the Imodium, and then it'll be all good. Line one, talk to us.
Hey, how you doing, George?
I'm doing fine. My finger's on the button. Talk to me.
I have a question about that girl over there. Are those girls for sale?
You know what? Listen, you're inbred. You're inbred. You need to get a life. Is your mama for sale? Can I see your mama?
You take the cake, George.
Line one, talk to me. Okay, the diarrhea, you need to take the Imodium. Line two, talk to me.
Hey, George, I was thinking about buying a ring for my girlfriend.
Okay, what kind of ring are you going to buy?
Well, that's not the problem. I was worried that she'd hawk it for men.
Okay. You know...
Hawk it for what?
Okay, you know, obviously that's an inside deal, whatever the deal is.
We miss your joke, man.
Yeah, live one, talk to us. Whatever.
I got something real fast here. I mean, y'all do want to crack on the wonder here. And I got a little post. It's gorgeous George's birthday, baby. And a lot of people want to talk about all this crap about me being fat.
Oh,
let me show you what time it is, baby. We're talking about being fat. Huh? Not being fat, baby.
Yes, sir. I want to hear it.
Ah!
Yeah! Ah!
Woo! People out there that wish you were me, get in line, baby, because I am.
Woo!
I am.
Woo!
The baby maker.
Woo!
And I don't know where to start.
We're trying to do comments and questions tonight. Okay, well, you know what? That's your mama's fat, you know. She's calling you to come home for breakfast. Matter of fact, she's got a dildo waiting for you to strap on. Well, strap on dildos to strap you on and teach you a lesson. Thank you very much. You're on the air. Comments and questions. Okay, you know what? You've got to take care of that. You know, the doctors told you that you have a bad stool. You need to take care of that. You need to take some vitamins or take a stool that makes your stool a little bit harder.
Eat some corn.
Because that stool softener you're taking is making your stool or making your bowel movement runny.
It was a delay.
So you need to take care of that. Matter of fact, you need to take your firstborn and flush it down the commode also with your stool.
It's Sylvia's right. Mother,
Sylvia.
Actually.
Sylvia.
She wants to talk about the Cowboys. So I think
all right.
Let's talk about it on the air. On the air with Gigi and friends, talk to us.
You suck that.
Hey. Hello?
Hey, I'm a Washington fan, and I had a question about the upcoming season this year.
Okay, what's your question?
Weight problem.
What's your problem?
Weight problem.
Okay, you must have a weight problem. Thank you very much. Lion, okay, weight problem, okay? Baby,
I can't believe he was
I mean, I can get out of this jacket right now and take it all off, you know. I really have to get out of this jacket and show you what time it is. I mean, come on. I mean, yeah, really and truly.
I think they rent your microphone.
Coming off.
They rent your microphone.
I'm going to take it all off right now. You know what, this baby, hey, I'll do the full
Stop body. When you get to the song.
Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us on line two, please. You know what? You should have taken, you know, that commode goes down, you got to take your doxidan.
Hello?
Hello?
Hey, I'd like to talk about the Yankees.
Talk about the Yankees.
Chances this year for winning would be best as if you got some.
Okay. The chances of you having, the chances of you were born were slim to none, but you were born, and it was an actual mistake. And you know what? Your daddy should have kept it in his pants. Thank you very much.
Talk to us. Okay, you know what? You need to take in lozenger in your mouth. Matter of fact, you need to open your mouth up so I can piss in it. Because when the piss comes out of my pot, it's more educational than what you want coming out of your mouth. Line one, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Hey, I love your show.
Thank you, sir.
All the fact you guys are on so late now, too.
Well, we're on late, but, you know, hey, I tell you, everybody's got to go to work the following morning. They got to punch that time clock, but we have been on for the longest time, and we have the time slot as 10:30 to 11:30. Actually, start early. Okay, you know what? I tell you what, people are just amazing. But anyway, comments or questions? You're on the air. Okay, you do that quite often, don't you? The tiny bubbles that work hard, so you don't have to. Why don't you flush your whole face down there and bop for your own log? Thank you very much. Line two, you're on the air. Okay, your mama's what? Your mama did what to you? She bends you over with a dildo? Oh my God, I'm sorry to hear that. Line one, you're on the air.
That explains it all.
Talk to us.
Hey, George, what's going on?
What's going on?
You're fat.
Okay, well, you know what? So are you. You're a homo also. Thank you very much.
How you doing?
Oh, hi, I'm good. I just want to say that I'm a relatively new viewer, but I can already tell you're all fucking...
All right. How you doing? Good to see you, pal. This is Kale's Ice Cavalcade of Fun.
Hello?
How you doing?
Hey, what's that big bag?
Yep.
Woo! And that camera needs to be adjusted.
I'll do it.
You gotta adjust
that
camera?
Okay.
My head's still being chopped off there. Let me, let me get over there and figure out what we're doing. Vince, take it away for a second.
All right, sure.
Okay. And I never like to say, have we fed you up pretty well?
Yeah,
okay.
Good.
That's too blurry.
Oh.
That's blurry.
Now you look good.
Okay, but my head is like chopped. Okay, back it up. Let me get over there. Okay.
Wait a minute. No, you can't go over there because I'm fat.
All right, look, you got it straight? Because I mean, I want to make sure we got it. Okay, it's still looking like my head is still being chopped here. Close up real fast because I'm serious. That close up does not work. Okay, this station has a lot of shows on its channel. It runs upon rotation, so we have to play that gamblet too and play that gamblet also. Someone has let out a stink bomb in here. I can smell it. Did you see a little stink bomb out here? Maybe some refried beans or some black bean sauce? But when I go on an air flight or go on an airplane, I don't want to have some brawly man put his hand on my crotch and enjoy it. Woo, baby, woo! Rubbing, rubbing, and rubbing.
Don't they want to just simply stop?
You look at it and you say, hey, you know, if it quacks like a duck, if it is a duck, it is a duck. And that's what it boils down to.
This is FCC regulations, which simply means that, yes, the callers who do call up this vehicle, the call up this channel, if they use vulgarity on the phone line, okay, they can be prosecuted. FCC regulations state that this is a vehicle, this is a TV show, and yes, if I choose to do so, I can prosecute.
The family show, and this is called Standards and Practices, Swiper Search.
Hey, I will deliver for you, and I'll give you the best baby you've ever had. Because it'll be the GG baby, it'll be the donation of my sperm, my jizz, the sperm, going to a beautiful woman out there that's husband that can't perform, and she'll be blessed. So just imagine that, my black thong that I'm wearing, and I'm thinking about you, and touching myself at the same time. When it comes to making love for you ladies out there, the glass is not half empty, baby. It's all the way half full.
Let me tell you right now, I'll speak for myself, I'm a heterosexual. Okay? Now, and you know what? And listen, you know, I'm always up for threesomes, you know, so if you got a girlfriend, maybe we can do a mariage matois.
Nice.
Wendy, you know, email me. And let's talk about maybe doing a dinner at Red Lobster. Woo!
The deal is either I'm attracted to, you know, I mean, I've been attracted to people that are either, you know, beautiful women that are lesbians. I'm attracted to women that are married or drug addicts. And that's my luck.
I mean, come on. The trailer park's out there. The cows are coming in. Meow.
Kevin, got anything to say before we do that?
Yeah. And all those chumps on the internet.
No.
They can play with themselves and roast marshmallows in the nude, as far as I'm concerned. I don't care.
I think...
Okay, they can play with themselves in a dark alley, as far as I'm concerned, and give high fives. I don't care. And you ladies have been missing my beautiful appearance on your TV screen, so you need to see my eyes on your camera. Well, Josephine, I'm thinking about you, and I'm touching myself at the same time thinking about you, because, Josephine, you give me such a rash, baby. When you're in your trying period, and when you're not doing such as good, you know, or not doing good, to say the least, well, these people, I wouldn't let my turd, I wouldn't let them watch my turd. Give you the high five and all that, but then they backstab you. They backstab you in the back. Or try to, you know, backstab you in the back. Oh, goodbye, no private call. Hasta fiesta. All right, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Hey, y'all were talking about backstabbers earlier. I had a story about someone that backstabbed me pretty bad.
Did you? Okay, let's hear it.
Yeah, this guy, shot my dog
and
took a crap on
him. Okay. See, bottom line is we really don't want to know about your love affair. You know, if you like to bestiality, we don't really want to hear about it. Okay, so take it to someone else here. We have had some old shows in Albuquerque, and we're working upon getting some old shows and some new shows in Albuquerque back on in that city.
That's great news. I'm really happy about that, you fat bitch.
Okay. Michael Rafferty is calling tonight, that pum scum. Hey, you need to let it die. You need to let it go. You are a buffoon, imbecile, and you keep calling tonight. We're going to keep mentioning your name, Michael Rafferty. Michael Rafferty, you keep calling, we're going to keep mentioning your name. We have the imbeciles calling up here, and a bunch of imbeciles. And we also have, you know, there are a lot of women out there that GG could have. A lot of women out there, you know, like Uma Thurman, you know, Kill Bill, you know, Uma Thurman, she would be a perfect contestant for Gorgeous George to impregnate. All right, Angela, you're on the air.
Hi, George. How are you doing tonight?
We're doing. How are you doing?
Pretty well.
What's your comments or questions tonight?
I was just on the cover of the show. And to tell you that we watch every week, and right, every time you're on, and we think you're a
tub of water. Okay. I think that you are pretty much looking at your boyfriend when you're saying that. I think that you have your expectations of a man is very low. I think when you're thinking of your boyfriend who's a tub of lard, but baby, when you ride Space Mountain, boo, then you know. You're on the air with GG.
Hello, Gorgeous George. I would like to start by apologizing to you for all the people that call in and harass you.
Okay.
People are just rude, you know.
Well, we know that.
All right, well, I would like to settle things in a friendly manner. I have a live journal. My username's Weave, W-E-E-V. And I would like to challenge you to a duel in a video game of your choice. I could do Super Smash Brothers, CVS 2. What do you want to play? You're a bag.
Line one. Talk to us. You're on the air. I'm sure you're on the air. Talk to us. Oh, God. Are you bathing in that? I want to know, are you bathing in that stuff? You need to bathe in it and flush yourself down. Well, I'm sure you're on the air.
You live with your mom.
Okay. You live with who? No, buddy, I live in a mansion. Okay? I make a six income figure. Come talk to me when you can do that, okay?
George, you're sad enough.
Okay, you know what? You take it. You rub dongs with your dad. Thank you very much. Come on, talk to me.
Man, you don't live in any mansion. Karen even told me you got a small.
Okay, okay, thank you very much. Line two, talk to us.
Hey, George.
Hello.
Seven oh three.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm wondering if you can sing a little bit more.
We'll probably have to put that on ice for next week.
Are you serious? Man, that made me so fucking...
Okay, you know what? You need to clean up your language and use some dye gel or use something down your throat. Use it like a lozenger with some turd on it and then... Put it down your throat with some water. Now tonight we're going to talk about Scientology. We're going to talk about we're going to talk about the Kabbalah. And we're going to talk about different religions such as the Mormons and such as the Jehovah's Witness. I mean, we these Scientologists. A lot of the stars are into Scientology. I think Madonna is one. And they also believe in reincarnation. Feel good religion, Scientology. I reformed the religious philosophy of Scientology, the Church of Scientology, because the Australian government banned Scientology to the scope of religious freedom in the country for Scientology, pursue Scientology training. Taxes imputed to all Scientology churches.
Hollywood weirdos like Tom Cruise.
Well, that's Scientology. Yeah, Scientology and the Bali. Of course, and the Mormons and the Jehovah's Witness. What do you do when a Jehovah's Witness comes to your door? You say, here's the candy. They say, trick or treat. I'm a Jehovah's Witness. Line one, you're on the air. Talk to us. I can't understand a word you're saying. You're talking out of your butt end. Thank you.
Is this a physical?
Why can't we eliminate these VCU retards from calling in my show? Why do these VCU retards have to keep calling in on the show? Line two, you're on the air.
George, dirt back.
Okay. Phil McCracken, you're on line two. Talk to us. Okay, you are a fork grinder. You're a pudge blunker.
Yeah.
Pudge mucker. Well, pudge,
that?
Yes. You take
pudge
it. You blunk. Take it in places we can't mention. Why would you want to talk to us?
Hey, how you doing? I had a question about Scientology.
We've got answers for you. Go ahead.
You want to do that?
Okay. Okay.
So basically, you're a dumb fat.
Yeah.
What ism are you talking about? You're breaking up here. What kind of ism do you want to know about?
Georgism.
Well, I can tell you Georgism. George is about you ladies out there when you feel kind of naughty and you want to worship somebody and you touch yourself in certain places. We can't mention it on TV because we get censored. But you touch yourself in certain places and you touch yourself.
Yeah.
Why don't you all there talk to us? You're bathing in your own urine. Good. Billy Dingle, how you doing? Line one. Hello. Oh, you're still bathing in it. Questions or comments tonight?
I just wanted to say that I enjoy the activity out there. I've been practicing for about a year and a half now, and I think it's a great sport for body fatness.
Thank you. Well, see.
Yes.
Hello.
Your hair.
Excuse me? Okay, line two. Hello? Oh, you're bathing in it. You're bathing in your own urine. Please, by all means. Two more calls. You're on the air. Talk to us. Hello?
Fat.
Okay, talk to us.
Hey, why are you so fat?
Okay, why are you so what?
Okay.
Hey.
So there's no women here. Okay, you're doing all these kicks, and this one you're working.
We can't. Let's go.
Step over.
Step
over.
Oh,
that
bus.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's do the short version. Okay? Now blocking form. Okay, Randy, what are we doing here? Here we go, number six. Okay, we did three. I can't do three times because it's less room. Go for the trigger there. This move takes someone out in the trachea. Okay. Okay. Now we're going to do. Okay.
What was that? She likes.
Yeah. Well,
that's good. That works out. So, I mean, have you ever had your tongue pierced or what?
No.
Never did? Never thought about it?
No.
Never thought about it?
Hurt.
Okay. You are a beautiful woman.
Thank you. I don't have a
microphone. Okay. Well, here.
Thank you.
You are a beautiful woman, and, you know, it's a shame. But, well, no, it's good. It's good, and I'm glad you're on my show tonight.
Thank you.
I mean that.
Thank you.
George.
Hello.
George.
Hello.
I have a question about why all these rude people are calling you.
That's right.
Calling you.
Let's talk.
Do they have a problem if you need a bullet?
Okay. You need to get a blow dry? Okay, thank you very much. I don't know about a blow dry. You might need a dry blow. I just make my... I'm so sophisticated. I've got it going on. I am the Mac. And that's all that needs to be said. Line two, talk to us. You're on the air. Susan Powers, no, not going
to make a call.
Okay, I guess not. Favorite school in Ashland.
Oh, yeah.
Randolph Macon in Ashland.
Randy Mac.
Favorite school. Well, I'll get to that in a second here. But all I'm saying is basically we bring this upon, you know, saying that, you know, if any people out there know what I'm talking about, especially, and I don't care if I get sued. Hey, bring it on. Hand Rocker Doctors, a piss-poor hospital. Hand Rocker Doctors, a real piss-poor hospital. I'll say it again. Yeah. You know, I wouldn't take my rat there to get tested. Or I wouldn't take my test tube.
If I were you, I wouldn't go there.
I wouldn't take my test tube fecal. My fecal little pet there.
I wouldn't go there for dandruff.
There you go. All right. Once again, I'm orchestrating this ring circus tonight. And you got a problem with that? You're not coming on.
Yes.
We begin to delve into the phone calls. Remember, it's my world, and you all are just participants.
You know us, but you know us does a lot of work, good work for the hospitals and the social workers. After the nurses, they're like almost as good.
Okay, line one, line two, line one. You're on the air. Talk to us. You're on the air. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. You're on the air. Comments or questions?
Yeah, I was watching that celebrity boxing last night, and like, I thought it was kind of weird. Like, they were watching Willis beat up on Vanilla Ice.
Ice Baby, yeah.
Yeah, I was wondering, how did you get the fuck?
Okay, obviously you need to have something to take care of that, because we didn't even hear what you were saying.
Good!
So there. this is something that I have a following in this town, and I've been doing this service, a public service announcement to all my fans out there that absolutely, positively... Worship me. Worship me and dig the persona that we do here on this vehicle. And I did say...
It was a mismatch.
Yeah, well, it was a mismatch. But I don't care what the people think. I think Tanya Harding is a cutie. I don't know.
Well, you know, the body has healing powers. There are people that go to Lourdes and claim that they're cured of...
Well, and it's funny that it's funny for you to mention that, because there are, of course, you don't believe in this stuff. I know you don't.
You don't believe
in these priestesses and, and these warlocks.
Hell
and
no.
And, well, I mean, there are a few people out there, Kevin, which, you know, I mean, I'm telling you.
You believe in it.
Well, I don't totally believe in it, but I do believe that there are a few people out there that know what they're doing. There are a few people that can do what they are, and they are healers.
you have priestess. Of course, you have, you know, people that believe in Christ, Jesus Christ and Christianity, that do their stuff. And then you have people that are downright out, do
frauds.
Magic. Well, supposedly there are, well, there are frauds too. You got frauds out there, but you got people out there that do the white magic.
It's
the black magic. Of course, that is, you know, basically Satan worshippers and whatnot, medicine men, Indian tribes that do. And some of these people know what they're doing. Mm-hmm. I mean, believe it or not, and I can tell you from what I've read that some of these people know what they're doing, and they are gifted, and they can heal people. As far as what they're different, the Indians out there, with the different, you know, tribute with the tribes and whatnot, and some of these people that are, dare I say, witches and warlocks. Even though you have your good ones.
You mean
ones.
Like Samantha and Darren?
You, well, I mean, you have your good ones and your bad ones. But
is it the old Darren or the new Darren? Well, I don't know.
But let me finish. You have your good ones and your bad ones. Your bad ones, obviously, you know, they do that wicked stuff. And your good ones out there, they do good stuff, too. But they believe in Wicca, the form of Wicca, and the form of white magic.
Wow, you know all about this.
Well,
stuff.
I mean, I know what I read, Kevin.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't totally, I'm not.
I always skip that page when I'm reading.
All right, on the air. You got an overbite? Yeah, you do. Line two. Okay,
what's he doing? Oh, who cares?
Wait, you're on the air. No?
Nobody cares.
You're on the air.
Hey, take it back, you bet.
Okay. Basically, you need to listen to me. You have been, obviously, when you were a kid, you know, you couldn't do anything. They thought you couldn't even speak. You couldn't even talk. Your mama's still giving you a bath, from what I hear, okay? Your mama and daddy are still giving you a bath. And obviously, when they do it, you know, they found out that when you were born, you were a male, but you didn't have the male organ. So, you know, whatever. They got to clean it because, obviously, you know, it needs to be clean.
You know what was weird about that guy? His father wanted a boy, his mother wanted a girl, and guess what? When he was born, both parents were happy.
Because you need to take care of that. You need an insertment, and you know what? We hear you from the bottom, but you got to take care of that front, because that front end of yours, the diarrhea is coming right out. I'll tell you what. Boo! You're on the air.
He needs some Imodium.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Okay. Whoops, I didn't hear you. Speak up there, sir. I couldn't hear you. There is a problem with the phone line tonight, Kevin.
I know.
It's called respect. If we don't have respect, we have a problem.
We have a.
If you don't have respect for yourself, then don't call me, because obviously a lot of you insecure people out there don't have respect for yourself, because the vocabulary that's coming through is a lack of respect. So when we hear any syllable, or when we hear any thing that sounds a little bit off-centered, we really don't hear it, because you got to speak up. You got to talk nice. You talk nice, you might get on. If you talk with a diarrhea, then you need to put some soap in your mouth, and you need to put a lozenger, you know, and get some of that white stuff out, okay? Because all that's in there is that white stuff, and it's coming out gerbil.
Yeah, they use to make the white line in the middle of the side of the highway.
We'll do one more, and then if this doesn't sound cool, then we're going to off we go. Because we are on TV, and we are special people.
Like a bad habit.
And we are on TV, and you know what? We've got it going on.
Yeah.
So whether you people, if you all people can do better than me, go right ahead. But I'm on here, I'm in control, and I'm doing it to it. I'm on TV, and we are syndicated in Baltimore, so blow me. Line below me, and just take a bow, because I am what's causing all of this.
You know, I got crabs once in Baltimore.
Did you?
They're very good.
Good.
Yeah.
Line two.
I'm fine, too.
How about what? Man, there is a lack of communication tonight. How about what? How about a lobotomy? Yes, buddy, you need a lobotomy.
No, how could he have a second one?
Not coming on. I recognize, not coming on. What's that?
Let me hug you, bitch.
Wow.
You know,
don't like that type of person calling, because we put women on a pedestal on this show. High enough to look under their dress.
One call out of how many? Tell you what, line one, line two.
Hello?
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 Hello? Goodbye. That's it.
Heck, we're over.
I'll tell you what, and we have done this with ease and charm. We are what's causing all this. We are the Gorgeous George Show. I'm sorry.
that we could not.
This is the hardest show I've ever done.
Is it really? I think it's easy. Because remember, the finger is mightier than the mouth. You know what I'm talking about? I could just sit here and do nothing and fix my hair and a bunch of women out there. I want some women callers tonight, dang it. I want some women callers. You got two attractive-looking Italian hunks here. Why? I'm Italian. I'm the hunk. You got a decent-looking guy here.
Yeah.
There's no reason why we can't have some women call tonight. Women out there that are who are admired by me. Women out there that are getting goose pimples by my fact of me being on TV. They're getting goose pimples. They're getting kind of giddy. They're getting kind of giddy. And they're getting kind of excited by the Italian God. So we want to have some women callers, for God's sakes. Kevin?
Yes. Yes, please call.
We don't. We are not this cocky. I mean, I'm not, you know, everybody's saying, are you that way in real life? Are you a cocky somebody in real life?
Yes,
I am.
We are.
What I am. Like Jesus said and Yahweh said, I am what I am. So you know what?
Yeah.
Take it for whatever you want to take it for. But understand this. When I say something, when I say the sea is going to part, the sea is going to part. When I say that it's time for a wake-up call, you best believe it's time for a wake-up call. Because 99.9% of what comes out of my mouth is
pure.
Is the truth.
Yes.
Is the God honest truth.
Now, Jesus said, I am what I am. Did he say that before he beat up Brutus and fought for olive oil?
Well, what's that song by Lindsey Buckingham and Fleetwood Mac? It says, I am what I am. I am what I am. You know.
Yeah.
A family man. What's it called?
It blew me down.
It's Blarney. Alrighty. You see, this is what we're about. We're improv, baby. And in case you've been under a rock and you haven't seen my beautiful face under your TV screen, we are probably the thing that's causing. Thank you very much. They're going to have to wait to their turn, D.
Because
if it's a woman, we'll take it. If it's not, two women?
Line two is a woman.
Okay.
It better be.
Now, you know what? It's probably that guy's male lover with the hormones. A male guy that has taken the female hormones down his mouth to sound like a woman.
Yeah.
We're gonna give it a try here and give it a go and give it a Wheel of Fortune a spin here.
Yeah.
But you got to be respectful. You got to say, Sir Gorgeous and Sir Kevin.
Sir,
and kiss my rings on my finger if I had some.
Yeah.
Okay. Treat me with respect and you get treated back with respect. I am what's causing this and I am causing the electricity to come on your TV screen, baby.
Line all the radiation.
To you and talk to us nicely. Hello.
Hello, children.
Okay.
I was wondering where that came from.
Okay. All right. Maestro.
It blends right into the
Maestro,
show.
Maestro, why did you tell me it was a female caller? Come on now. Yeah. Tell me it was a female caller, right? We don't want to hear her in the bathroom.
I was suspicious of her.
You were suspicious?
Yeah, I was suspicious.
Yeah.
She's
sounding guilty.
Yeah.
Guilty. I mean, guilty before being innocent, right? That's obvious.
But women tend to act.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's right. Okay.
Bring it out in them.
Well, no. I think it's their upbringing. I think the mama should have taken like a wooden spoon and
a hairbrush to
whip them with it. Line one, you on the air.
Hello.
This is like clown college.
His mother, he's got his mother to call up here so he can pick up the phone and say something. No, better yet, he's got his male lover with the hormones, the female hormones in his mouth that sound like a woman, okay, to call up here. Okay,
but you
might get the woman or you might get the female person to call or whoever with the female hormones, and you might get two symbols out. But pop you go. You know, pop goes the weasel. Because you are a freaking weasel as far as I'm concerned. Pop goes the weasel. You know what I'm talking about. Line two, you're on the air.
Hello?
Hello.
Hi.
You're on the air.
Hey, George.
Hey.
Hi.
Yeah, can you pick me up from again?
I don't pick up women for people. I pick up women for my own self. Thank you very much. Take lessons low from me, okay?
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Line one.
Go to the personal ads.
You're on the air.
Hey, George.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, I had a question for the guy, your friend there.
Kevin.
Hey, man, are you gay?
No. Boy.
See, I bring out the best in a lot of men that call. That, yeah, they fall in love with you and me. But nah, we, you know, we love the ladies.
My name is Gorgeous George. Not Slim Shady, not Eminem, but TG, Gorgeous George. Sing with me. My name is
Eminem, no, with peanuts.
GG. On the air.
Howdy.
Hello.
Gosh.
Orchestra. Line two. On the air.
I'm sorry.
Did I hang up the phone to you? I'm sorry. Can't we have one? This is our last show until July.
Yeah.
Can't we just have one call?
Yes.
Just one call with intelligence.
This is what we have to take with
us. I beg you. I implore of you. We want to talk to you, and we want you to talk to us. But please, for the sake of humanity and for the sake of me being on your TV screen, I want to talk. But I want to talk to someone with intelligence. There's bound to be somebody out there. It's bound to be somebody out there who can be able to talk with some intelligence.
Yeah.
He sounds like he might have a little bit of intelligence.
You think?
He sounds like he has.
Are you sure it's not that? Okay. Well, remember, we can still test it.
Yeah. Well,
I want to find out what you guys had to say about the situation with George Bush and the arsenic in the water.
George Bush and arsenic and water.
He does not. Yeah, he won't. He won't come down hard on the companies who won't clean up the arsenic in the water.
Well, I think, Lo, that Bush and arsenic are two different. I think Bush needs to take the arsenic, pretty much.
Do you think he should drink his own urine like you?
Okay.
He got us confused with Gandhi.
Did you obviously hear that call? Basically, yes. Talking with a topic and then trying to put it back. You know, because you see, I didn't hear that. Did you hear that? No. Now, Bush needs to take arsenic. And, buddy, you also need to take a little bit of arsenic, too, obviously. Thank you very much. Respect.
He's arsenic and old face.
Respect. Line one.
Hello.
Talk to
us. George.
Hello.
Hey, I was wondering about the cars you were talking about earlier. The top 10 worst cars.
Right.
What car do you drive?
What I drive? I drive. I have two cars. I've got a Beamer, and I've got also a Volvo. Thank you.
Yeah, but I think we got excited over that.
I'm glad that it excites
you. Orgasm man.
I tell you what, sprinkler man. I'm glad that you like that. Basically, and I'm glad that you're turned on by that. Line two.
Oh.
Line two.
Hey, how you doing?
Hey.
Okay.
We can't.
The guy's in ecstasy.
Yeah, I'll tell
you.
When
he's eating his boogers.
That's what he said?
Yeah, it's evidently. Okay. Yeah.
All I can tell you is rubbers. Your dad should have used one. Rubbers. Your dad should have used one. For God's sakes.
I can't believe out of 60 million sperm, his one.
Jesus. Line two.
Homosexual.
Who are these folks?
Why what? No, I guess
not. Do we have like a pipeline to the city jail or something? like the holding cell.
They want to basically, you know,
yeah,
run the parade.
Is this the Daily Planet is calling?
Yeah, I don't know what it is, basically. they must be calling from a payphone and using speed dial. Calling from a payphone using speed dial, basically.
Yeah.
You need the Italian stallion. What you need, baby, is you need to be... Chilled. Whoa. You need to be cooled off by Gigi. Because, baby,
right.
I can cool you and I can heal you with my eyes. Line two, NASCAR. And your take on NASCAR. Well, okay, I'm not going to justify that. I'm going to say that's my opinion. I'm entitled to that opinion. And once again, Kevin, I know you.
Yeah.
It's not a sport. NASCAR is not a freaking sport. Thank you very much. The last letter
you're entitled to George's opinion.
Exactly. Thank you very much. Dear Gorgeous George, we know that you are right now back on. Whatever happened to the girl in Las Vegas? The girl in Las Vegas, and whatever happened to her? Are you going back out there? And are you going to do a live shoot sometime there? I am going to go back there. I am going to do what I can. The situation is very, very tedious. I am going to go back there. I'm going to pretty much give it all I got and try to win her over and try to get her back. And if I can do it, great. And I'm going to do what I can to get my girl.
Yeah.
That's all I can say. I don't like to get that kind of...
In fact, bring her back. Yeah, bring her back.
So,
and we'll have
that's some of the peanut gallery right there, and we're talking to the peanut gallery. Like I said, tonight...
Peanut gallery.
Peanut gallery.
I was wondering about
You wondered about the guests, yes. Okay, now we're going to take this call. Remember once again... Because we've got a certain somebody that likes to get vocal. I mean, like I said, I am in charge of this assembly tonight.
Yeah.
So, you know, you're going to say whatever you want to say. I am in charge, baby. I'm in charge. GG, in effect, is in charge of this ensemble. What is causing all this? I am what's causing all this. And tonight, you call up and you say, Sir. Sir Gorgeous George. Sir Kalazar.
Yeah.
And you talk with respect and dignity. Because if not, exit door. Line two,
you're on the
air. Talk to us.
Sir.
How you doing?
Hey.
How you doing?
I like him already.
Thank you very much. I want to sing a song right here about Doc Sedan. Doc Sedan. Okay, go ahead. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Yeah, the show's great.
Thank you.
I really like the beginning. Good morning. Now, how does that work? Do you deliver food for...
Alrighty. Line one. Talk to us. You on
the
air? Okay. Thank you very much. All right. That's the way it goes. Out the door you go. Thank you for the compliment, but I'm not going to let you finish off. You're going to get up and say whatever you want to say, but you're not going to get the opportunity to finish what you were going to say. Because I know I'm in charge. I'm two steps ahead of the game. Two steps ahead of the game, but not 10 steps.
Yeah. Maybe 12 steps. You can see him in the basement at the church next week.
We are going to be back. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Doxidane, when nature needs a little helping hand, put that little capsule at my little thing there. When I feel so constipated, Kevin, you know what I'll do?
I'm waiting on pins and needles.
I put it in some Doxidane, when nature needs a little helping hand. Hey, baby, we are live, but I have not given up on the comical stuff. My foundation is not political. My foundation is not talk show. What I'm about is shock entertainment. Mm-hmm. And that persona is coming back on here one way or the other. I've been toned down. I play the game. I play the rules. Talk show persona.
Yeah.
You know, I think I do pretty good for, a talk show host,
for
you know, whatnot.
House cat,
but we are going to do and bring back the bathroom humor.
Yes,
we are going to bring back... the comical skits that were the true foundation to the show.
Right on.
Kevin?
Yes, let's do it.
Let's do it to
it. Let's make it happen.
Let's make it happen. Now, you go with number two in worst cars anyway. So
yeah, I feel like Kathy
That's Lee. Pretty much it. So now, not only do you all get to see Gigi, you also get a lesson. You see Gigi blessing your screen, boo, and making your girl's dress fly in the air with excitement and extra leakage in your seat. But you also get to see Gigi, and you get an education every single week that we're on the camera.
Some woman tells me that she watches this show with her friends, and at the end of the show, when she finished watching the show, there's a dry seat in the house.
That's right. Line two, you're on the air.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
I can't believe you're going off until July.
Say what?
I can't believe you're going off July?
We're coming back on in July.
Yeah, coming back in July.
I'm going to miss your bloated ass.
All right.
All righty.
Hello, my God.
How much of asshole cream?
Yes,
when you take a little asshole cream, it is pale as blue, there is no hair down the bottom, it makes your asshole look white.
Me and my friends, we laugh at you when you walk down the hall and you fart at night.
I fart? If I fart, it's so overwhelming. It's
it's funny, Grandpa.
Come on, I'll take you down the store. And all through the house.
Mm-hmm.
Not a farm animal would stir.
Mm-hmm.
Not even the farm rat. The puss that was up there.
Oh,
yes. And while stockings were hung in care, so was Agnes with stockings hung in care, that gorgeous George...
You don't have no teeth, Grandpa.
I have no teeth, baby. I can still do this.
Grandpa, you scare me.
I scared
you. I know I do. Pretty.
Well, this is like this. It was to the and all through the house. Not a creature was stirring, not even a song.
How you guys doing tonight?
What's up?
Hey, Kay, I was at the Bruce Springsteen concert. I saw you sitting down in the same section. It was a great show. I'm wondering
Hello. It was great to see Bruce, and I'm glad, and you should have said hello, and I had a wonderful time, and thanks for...
I was wondering why you didn't sit next to George. Is it you want to know one thing I love there?
Oh, no.
No, you're starting job.
I know. Let me tell you something about...
You want me to talk to us?
Danny Colbert here, only in America, could have shown this great with two fat guys.
Okay. You know what? Your mom is fat, and you know what? She had you at the Sizzler, and now she needs to deposit you down the commode. Thank you very much. Playing this weekend, so we hope that happens. All right, we're going to be taking some phone calls. This is the Gorgeous George Show, and remember who's in charge of this ring circus. Hello. I guess I wasn't that important, so I'll go ahead and fix my hair a little bit here. Fix it up even more here. I'll take it from inside here. Hello?
George.
Hello.
What's going on?
Not much.
Really?
Comments or questions tonight? Yeah, really. But I'm glad you called to say really to, and thank you. Not much going on tonight, but I'm on TV, blessing your TV screen, but thank you for noticing. Woo! Tell you what. Anyway, so we got that to talk about. We got another call here we're going to grab. Hello? Ah, you're playing with yourself again. Okay, we can't, you know, if you're unplugged with yourself, we don't want to know about it. That's your personal problem. You need to take it somewhere in a corner.
George, how are you doing?
Comments or questions?
Want to talk about Obama?
Go right ahead.
Yeah, you're talking about a situation where someone called him a communist or a socialist.
Right.
You're sitting here tonight, you're advocating a socialized medical system. You're also advocating the Obama tax plan, which he told Joe the Plumber yesterday that he wanted to take his money and spread it around. Spread it out evenly. So that is, by definition, socialism. So Obama is a socialist, and you are a fat.
Okay. Well, you know what? You are an idiot. You are an idiot. Okay, your comment tonight, okay, is one thing about being political. When you get personal, buddy, you become an idiot. You become a ass grinder, okay? You take your head, meet and greet your own log, flush your log with your head down and come out at the same time, and that would be equivalent to the phone call.
Yeah, I want to talk about Tony Romo. I don't think it's a good idea for him to play with this injury. It's a situation where the Cowboys could get hurt here, just like you could get a disease from the Craigslist.
Line two. You're on the air.
Hey, George, did you get lucky with that prostitute last week?
Did you get nasty with me? You get indignant? This is what we do. That will drown your ass out, okay? Go ahead.
Hey, George, how you doing?
What's going on?
Not much. I just want to say I enjoy the show. It's a pretty good show. I'm not going to lie to you.
Okay.
I would also like to say you do have a fat ass.
Okay. Well, you know what? We're not talking about your mama, okay? Your mama's got the fat ass. You know, that's fine. We're not talking about your mama, so we don't care about fat asses. Okay, now if you're saying that she's got a fat ass, no, she's got a sweet ass. She's sweet. So be kind to our guests. Yeah, talk to us. On the air, talk to us.
Somebody nut in your hair.
Well, you know what? I don't know about who nutted in your hair, but it seems like you have no nut. It seems like you have a vagina down there, and you're trying to grow some down there. We don't want to hear about that, because you know what? This is what me and your mom did last night.
woman.
Hey, George.
Okay, what's going on?
Fuck you.
Well, you know what? Why don't you go dig for your own, okay? Put a large lot of turd in your mouth and then come back and talk to us then. Matter of fact, why don't you swallow your own fecal matter? Thank you very much. You're on the air. Talk to us.
George, why are you eating
loaded? Why don't I do what? I didn't hear you quite what you were saying. Why don't you do what? With your mama's breast? No, I don't just take any lactation milk. I mean, I like, the milk has got to be pretty good, but I don't buy for any, I don't just take any kind of milk. You know, because sometimes the lactation milk is sometimes kind of sour, and I am, you know, lactose intolerant, or intolerant, you know, so
but there the milk's still good.
But the milk is good as long as it's coming from the right one.
Hello. I thought you might be going
hold that thought. Hold that thought. Sleep.
What?
Sleep.
Who knows you so well?
Now, I want sleep. Now, lay back. I want you to bark. Bark like a dog.
Bark, bark, bark.
Get Obama as a communist. I don't think there's a lot of stuff about Obama being a terrorist and what. No, Obama is a smart, intelligent man.
It's Kenya.
You're on the air. Talk to us.
Which is not her.
Hello.
Okay.
You know what? You need to take your head. Okay. After you do the do, take your head, meet and greet your waste matter, and then go bobbing. And then flush your waste matter and your head at the same time down the commode, because what we need to hear from you is equivalent to a gastroreal fart. Better yet, equivalent to a bunch of matches lighting up a building, and you know. So actually, you know what it's equivalent to?
What? That's a good thing. No.
Actually, it's equivalent to this.
I think that's a sound that
hold on. It's equivalent to this. Now, there are a bunch of people in the hell that are burning in hell by the pitchfork, and they're like, you know, there's like a bunch of men getting off in slow-mo. There you go. That's what it's equivalent to.
I think that cost
me. Why two?
Hey, how you doing, George?
What's going on?
Do you honestly believe that Obama will win the election?
I honestly believe that Obama will win the election.
I do agree with you. I think he is a very smart and intelligent candidate. I actually think McCain is very focused on just the war, and I do not agree with that. What do you think?
Well, I tell you, Obama at least had his deal where he said that he opposed the war. I had issues in the beginning with Obama, but what got me on the Obama train is when he did his speech at the DNC. When he did the speech in the DNC, it proved to me that he knew what he was talking about. It was very Clinton-esque. And you know, if you know anything about me, you know I'm a Bill Clinton supporter. His speech was very Clinton-esque, and I think that the rift between the Clintons and him have gone past. Bill Clinton has backed him, so has Hillary, so therefore I back him also.
I completely agree with you on that, George, actually. I would just like to know how far have you set your partner in crimes, asshole?
Well, as far as you take your partner in crimes, asshole, being your daddy. We don't rub dongs with our daddies on this TV set. You rubbing dongs with your daddy, that's your personal bet. We don't want to hear about that. You're on the air. Talk to us.
Yeah, that guy makes it. I mean, I hate when a caller's going to call in and act like he's serious, and then he can't be serious like that. It makes me mad. Well, it makes me mad to look at the fat bitch right there.
Okay, well, you know what? Compared to what you have in your house? Okay, we don't need to hear any disrespect to a woman on TV. She's out here tonight. No disrespect, okay? Compared to what you have in your house, your wife or your sister or your mother or maybe your granny, perhaps your granny and you do it together and you go digging down there and it's very prunelicious. Thank you very much. You're on the air.
Hello?
Hello.
Talk to us. Questions or comments?
Hey, George.
Hey.
Hey, man, I just was wondering. I just had a couple of questions. Number one is, I was trying to take count, and I kind of lost count. How many chins do you have?
How many chins do you have? How many slurpees or herpes that you have in your ass? How many snots you have in your nose? Okay, you know, how many chins did I have? How many chins do you have? Actually, we can't hear you so clearly because you're talking out of your rectum. Speak up so we can hear you better. Because we don't need to hear some gas on here.
Ooh. Yeah, I never thought they could fit three.
You never thought what? I didn't quite understand. I'm sorry. Were you trying to say something? No, I didn't quite hear you. I'm sorry. Line 7.
Hey, George,
did
you ever
call
anybody ask me to get the tip wet?
Excuse me? Line 10.
Hey, George, how you doing tonight?
I'm doing fine. Hands on the button. What's up?
I'm Team Marsh, just sitting here watching the show, enjoying it. Good show tonight.
Okay.
I love the dancing.
You say what?
I love the dancing earlier.
Dancing with the Stars, yes.
Yeah, you fat fuck.
You know, they were going to ask me to go in there, and I said, hey, put me in. But I was very selective who I was dancing with.
Really?
Yes.
Good stuff.
Excuse me?
Good stuff. You can get like a cock.
You're someone's by cock. No, we don't care about your personal elements. If you like it, that's great, but I don't care to know that you like that. That worries me. You're on the air. Talk to us.
Got a promise?
You do what? You did what? What did you do to your granny? You actually you popped your granny's cherry? Oh my God, did you pull right back her hat? No more calls. Line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Yes, I have a question.
I've got an answer.
You're a fat.
Okay, you know what? I'm a fad. Well, no, I'm a fad in most countries. You know, I'm a fad, but I am what's causing all of this, baby. And whether you like it or don't like it, shut up and eat your banana. Okay, line two, you're on the air. Talk to us.
I said it.
You know what? I said rub dongs with your granny and your dad and your mommy. Okay, because she's got one too. Okay, obviously. I mean, she's a trisexual. It's obvious. Line two, talk to us. Okay, you know what? You know what? Something, you've got to see a doctor. You've got to call 911. Get on your phone and say, Dr. Feelgood, I've got the cooties. My bowels are loose. Well, let your doctor take care of that, because I'm sure the people that are listening to this channel don't want to hear that, and neither do we. We don't want to hear that neither.
No.
Line one, you're on the air. Talk to us.
Yes, George.
Yes.
Do you know Jimmy Craig?
Jimmy Craig.
Jimmy Craig.
It's what?
Jenny Craig. She could probably.
Okay. You know what?
I don't know where it's going. Yeah.
Jenny Craig.
Jenny Craig.
We know about Jenny Craig. I don't know. Do you know about Jenny Craig? What? What you say?
Jenny
Craig. This car is still on here. Line one.
Did you eat another man?
You've got a gerbil up there, and I can't. So you need to take care of that problem. Line one. Talk to us.
That Star Wars speak that they know so well.
Talk to us.
Yeah, I think it's really funny that you say that I lost my dad, because you're a fat.
Okay, you know what? First of all, this is your father, Mr. Michael Rafferty, right here. I'm Jeff Father.
All right.
Line one, talk to us.
Yo, man, get out the Krispy Kreme diet.
Okay, you know, Krispy Kreme's to you, too. We got this person, and I want to address to this person right out of here. You are a dancer, okay? And you got this punk boyfriend of yours. He calls my answering service and say, if I call you again, you're gonna, you know, let me tell you something, punk. I'll call her again, whether you like it or don't like it, and then I'll slap you across, slap the taste out of your mouth, and you know what? You all like it, because I said so. We got Skits coming. Talk to me, caller. Line two, please.
Yeah, hey, George, how you doing?
What's up?
All right, I just have two words. Wait, watch.
Obviously, you are insecure about yourself. Obviously, you use a towel to wipe your behind. Thank you very much. Talk to me, caller. Thank you for your call. Line one, talk to me, caller. You're on the air.
You keep on talking about respect, but it seems like the only person you respect is yourself. And you doesn't seem like you practice what you preach.
Well, elaborate a little bit, because first of all, I can't barely even hear you because you're talking really, probably the phone's not close to your mouth. But, I mean, I heard what you said, I mean, about respect. I respect people, okay? And really and truly, you don't even know me to even say that. Once again, you're...
I mean, what I've seen on your shows, you're just, like, hanging up on people and saying you're, like, the god of the world, and really you're not.
Well, I'm not, you know, hanging up on people. And if people don't have anything intelligent to say, then that's when the phone goes down. But you're still on, so...
That's a misconception.
Kind of elaborate a little bit more here.
I don't know, you're, like, talking about how you'll... Like, all the women want you, and I really can't see that.
Well, obviously, the boyfriend that you go with is probably a redneck. He's probably a fat slob. Thank you very much. Call Timmy Tall Line 2. Past weekend, we had the Gorgeous George pageant that was aired on Continental Cable TV. We had a lot of people think that I was creating child pornography by having girls on the show from U of R and, you know, seven girls from U of R. These girls were fully dressed. So I don't see where I was, you know, promoting child pornography. Dave, I tell you what, and for people to think that I was trying to do child pornography on my last show, you are sadly, sadly mistaken. This was something, see, because people are jealous of me. I have a lot of enemies out there. Even before I did the show, I had a lot of enemies out there. But I don't care, because I do the show because I feel the need to do the show. You're on the air.
Hey.
What's up?
Hey.
Hey. Hey. You're on the air. Talk to us.
Listen, so I see your cleavage. What size cup are you?
Baby, if you want to know and feel, why don't you bring your head a little closer and I'll breastfeed you. Take it off, basically. Okay, come on. I think it's crap. What's in here, lying, whatever. Talk to us.
Thanks for calling.
Thank you. Talk to us.
Hello.
Hello.
How you doing?
How you doing?
I was just wondering why the guy on the left looks like Urkel and you're a fat ass. And
yeah. Well, thanks.
Okay. Let me tell you something, okay? You see, cut him off, okay?
I think he was looking in the mirror.
Maybe you're looking back at him. Maybe you're looking yourself in the mirror, and if you had anything to say to me, okay, you can go ahead and take your face and dump it down the commode, because, buddy, don't get personal with me. You don't even know who I am. I could be your worst freaking nightmare.
Hey, I saw you on the internet. I'm from out of town, and I couldn't believe it. I turned on the TV, and here was Gorgeous George.
There you go.
Yes.
While we're here, live in camera, we'll be back on in the summer. We're doing a promo show. Right. Line one, talk. Yeah. Yes, you're on the air.
You're a fat fuck.
Excuse me?
You're a fat fuck.
All right, okay. Yeah, we heard that.
He's calling me Nico.
All right. Nico.
Nico for sure.
Nico.
But don't make fun of George's show. This is serious television enterprise we're trying to do tonight. Right. So no make with the levity.
Okay, well, thank
no
you.
No levity to do tonight. Right. So
Anyway, we try to be very honest and very forthright on this show. And let me tell you that there was...
You mercenary.
How many times I tell you, we don't give the opposite...
Oh, yes. Oh, no. Here we go.
I told you that. All right.
And they're... All right. We offended...
Birthday celebration, we did the roast, and I was taking it on the chin. And I didn't really get that. I didn't really call Smirnoff doing your buddy.
Oh, Yakov, we've been yakking off the Yakov all week.
Whoa! Look at this.
What was that?
I thought you were going to show Mona Lisa.
Look at this. Beautiful as I can always look. I'm changing the numbers in the West End July 30th. So, community access.
Somebody's playing the theremin, or it's an old science.
Like every woman wants to touch me because it's not my fault, baby. Close up. So they want to touch me, baby, because I'm beautiful. Ladies want to touch my body because I am so beautiful, baby. Woo! Woo! Woo!
You know?
Whoa! Bullseye!
You know?
Whoa! Bullseye!
Certain psychological problem you may have, it make you better person, you know. It's your low self-esteem is what I'm concerned.
Low self-esteem.
Yes, you're this shy, retiring violet. Or else put a bag on your head, I don't know which.
Sandra Day O'Connor was a conservative, but she was a little bit more neutral. What is that humming coming?
It's that science fiction movie again.
Okay, yes. We need to take that down. All right, bring that down.
It came from outer space.
Yeah, thank you.
Ahead,
let me have my guitar.
Check
it bigger guitar. I just told you to get a bigger, better wrench. Okay. So you can go to the heavy door. And you're trying to go to the heavy door. Check it bigger, better wrench. Come and get it.
You know what?
Uh oh. Yeah. Somebody's calling. Come and get it.
I didn't know you could do that.
Uh-oh.
I didn't know you
could
do that.
Wait, no, it's working.
Yes.
You can't hear it.
Play that funky music, white boy.
So we don't take private calls.
You big dummy.
Someone's calling me for private call here.
And turn it off.
Put it up.
We need to turn this damn thing off.
There you go.
Turn it off.
No.
We don't take personal calls.
No, we don't.
Does Jay Leno and Letterman do it?
No, we don't. And it just needs to go off right now. Okay. Yes. There you go.
Ho!
Have you heard of Five Guys and a Burger? I tell you what, Five Guys and a Burger. And guess who the mascot is for Five Guys and a Burger? Here you go. Can you recognize this little bastard right here? Five Guys and a Burger. He's the mascot.
Oh, my word.
Now, watch me.
This is sacrilege.
I want my burger medium well. Oh, I didn't know that. Listen to me. I want my burger with mushrooms and sautéed with mushrooms and veggies. You're not going to do it? There you go. You're not going to do it? There you go. Next time when I come to your establishment, you give me what I want. If I come into your establishment, you give me the food that I want, I'll go to your superior. And I don't care if you're the mascot. I don't care if you're the mascot with 5 men in a tub. I mean, 5 men in a burger. Rub-a-dub-dub with 5 men in a tub. I don't care.
Do you want fries with that?
Yes, thank you. That's more like it. I want my veggie and I want my rice pilaf. I had to do that.
Pull around to the second window.
So these people want to talk about where I work at and say I used to do odd jobs and I used to cater. What about that buffoon that works? We used to have a show on this channel that works at the establishment Five Guys and a Burger. I don't. What a joke. He used to say, "Oh, delivery boy. Oh, pizza boy." Well, you know what? I've had all the odd jobs in the world. This buffoon right here, who's works at Five Guys and a Burger at an ECU. So harass the hell out of him. Harass the hell out of that bastard. Thank you. I had to do that.
It's very good likeness. Yes.
Yeah. And also, wait. Give me back my son. Oh. Give me back my son. Give me back my son. Give me back my son.
Give me back my son.
All right. I had to do that. I'm sorry. Now,
put them both together.
You took some pictures.
Yes.
Okay.
We just got back from press.
Together. Together forever. Together forever and ever and ever.
And I always will.
Make his lip, you know, make his lip someone, sneer. Yeah. Make his lip sneer.
You know, someone said,
make his
someone,
lip, someone put the sneer on the lips.
Someone said the world's a bed and had your legs apart. Well, you know. Act one is when we met and you were mine, sweetheart. You seem a strange and that could change. Must have been on your period or something. But I don't know. Honey, you lied when you said you'd get down on me. And I had no cause to doubt you. I don't want to go anymore listen to no more of your lies and going on sleeping without you. And now you're lying there, and I'm standing here with breast milk all around. And honey, if you won't go down on me, I gotta pull your panties down. Is your heart filled with pain? Should I come back someday? Tell me, dear, are you horny tonight? We play the rotation gamblet here. Charnel, if you would, please. Okay. Oh, yeah. Man, nose hair coming off. I'm like, sure.
You want your Brill cream?
One natural specimen, baby. One natural.
Oh, and natural.
So beautiful and gorgeous, we all know that.
You're quite the specimen in that yellow coat.
Nah, it's not yellow, Kevin. Kevin, it's not yellow. It's green.
Oh, like Trump.
Louis Armstrong.
It reminds me of a cow that I used to be in another life. I was hoping that you would have a caller and I would tell him.
Not on this show.
Yeah, well, you know. It is gone down. Hey, time flies by.
But wait a minute. No. It's coming up. It's coming. Oh, this was what I had in mind for some of your caller friends.
Yeah.
But we show that to the people. Okay. Oh, be careful.
Yeah, it's not. Okay.
Yeah, this is.
Actually, here you go. There you go. Mm.
Yeah. Don't break my snot. Don't break my snot. This is my snot.
How are you going to make any more snot if you keep breaking
this? This is my good snot. My best snot you break.
I'm sorry.
Who do you think I am? Snotsky? Snotsky from Trotsky.
Snotsky. Yeah, you may think it's funny, but it's snot.
There you go. Boris is very sad. Boris is going to drink.
Ooh, it is forehead. All right, last 3 minutes, we're going to delve into calls. I mean, time does fly by when you're having fun, obviously. We're going to delve into calls last 3 minutes. Okay, I said, the Mighty Ducks.
This is the new Mighty Ducks show now. Wait a minute.
It's all right, vodka makes all things good.
Thank you, Kevin. We can recreate it. Thank you so much.
There you go. We'll put this on eBay here.
comes from.
Put on eBay. All right, that must be my contractor right there.
Right. Pure grade industrial waste.
Okay, is it? Okay. All right. Okay, Brandon Arthur is not coming on, so goodbye to you. All right, you got
to
call last.
Talk
week.
To Hootie.
That's right. Ah.
Hootie.
What do we got going on there, Captain?
Hootie.
You dancing?
He's okay. Dancing. He's dancing. All
right. Hey, it's Walt all right. Disney all over again.
Yes, sir.
All right.
Talk to Hootie.
Something. Unknown call. All right, we're going to delve into it. 513-4436. You unzip the app. Talk to us.
Hey, how's it going?
It's trying to go. Comments or questions tonight?
I had a question tonight. I was wondering why you called yourself a cow.
Excuse me?
Oh. Is that the cow Mary called?
No, he's a buffalo. He
I called him a cow.
I don't know what you're talking about, what you're smoking, but anyway. All right, why I called myself a cop or a cow?
Cow.
Oh, cow.
Cow.
Yeah, well, anyway. We know
I thought we had a much smarter audience.
Okay, private calls, goodbye. Yeah, make it count, because we only got 3 minutes left in the show.
That's
here.
All right.
Woo!
Girl is calling, Amanda Hug-a-Kiss.
Amanda Hug-a-Fiss. Okay, we got a 703 every code. You on the air, talk to us. Okay, you know what? Can you all do any better than that? Can you all do any better than that? I mean, be more creative, for God's sakes. Get a life.
Hootie.
Private calls.
Hootie is here.
Goodbye to private calls there.
Talk to Hootie.
My butt got on.
Well, I don't care if Jesus is here.
Line one, Anita Mandalay.
Okay, let's not tell me a private call or not here. But okay,
all right.
Ramada Inn West. What the hell's?
Oh, classic.
Ramada Inn. Hey, what is it? Watching from a hotel.
Okay. Line one, you're on the air. Ramada Inn, I think. Go ahead. Oh, I guess not.
Well.
Anyway, you need to make a count. I'll tell you what. I mean, a bunch of just ignorant VCU retards. That's all it is. A bunch of ignorant VCU retards. We talked about some intelligent stuff tonight about credit cards and all that, and yet we keep getting private cards.
You don't see us, but we see you.
You can clean up. You can clean your house a little better than what you
we
got.
We are on television. We are better than you.
Okay, this, we gotta cut you right off there, obviously.
Louis Armstrong's
Max Squirrels. Wow. Go ahead, talk to us.
That's loud.
Yeah. Hello.
He's gone.
Hello, Matt Squirrels, Squirrelies, or whatever. You're on the air. Guess not.
Not enough.
We grabbed the squirrels by the nuts there.
Well, hold on, try it. You're on the air. Talk to us. Hello.
Guess not.
And so then we reflect, and then of course we got 1 minute left. So.
Phil McCracken, line two.
Phil McCracken. All right, private calls, goodbye. Yeah. We're not taking private calls, so
only intellectual.
You're wasting time here. No private
deep
calls.
Thought, intellectual thoughts. It's all we want.
All right.
Okay. Lots
Dick
of thoughts.
Dick Wrong, line two.
Dick Gizenwell. You're on the air. Dick, go ahead. Talk to us. Hello.
Hey.
Hey, I just wanted to say happy birthday, Scott.
Okay. Happy birthday, Scott. A fabulous guy. You know what, lady? You need
happy
to take
birthday.
The squirrel from under your thing down there and put it up your butt in because we didn't quite hear you. Thank
Nobody
you
for, wishes me a happy
thank
birthday.
You for happy
Come
birthday.
On.
Okay.
You got yourself lucky, pal.
This is the Gorgeous George Show, baby. One Mona Lisa, one leader in Tower of Pisa, baby, and only one. Gorgeous George. Believe it, woo, or not.
Thank you.
All right.
Getting
let's
a touch
on the music going out or the win here. There we go. We got it?
Bob.
You got it?
I'm Saturday Night Live.
Okay.
3 minutes, but I don't know anything to do. All right.
No. Let's go. Ladies and gentlemen, here we go with a song. Hope you enjoy. Raise it up. I'll give you the best that I
can
give you, baby. That's all
Jesus
that I can give you.
Man, you break my
snot. Any activity outside?
You break my snot.
No, it's still ringing. Baby, baby,
that's long. You're on the air.
No, we're not on the air.
Hey, watch over the mic here.
The
mic's getting broken.
Never turns you down. What kind of love lifts you off the ground? Turns your life around. What kind of love
Don't you go out in the rain and the driving wind. What kind of love? Only this love that I have.
And Miller, if you're listening out there, put your head in here. Come to my door. Knock on this door right here. I dare you. Knock on this door right here, motherfucker. Miller, you come to my house. I will maim you. I will maim you. I will maul you till you can't get up off the floor. Till you can't get off the freaking floor. I am in control. I have been in control. Keep it going. Brennan, you bring it. Give it your best shot. Because, Brennan, I swear, as the sun rises, I'm going to make you pay. I'm going to make you pay for everything you've done to me. Bank on that.
Oh, wait a minute.
Once makes you go out in the wind and the driving rain.
Wait a minute, you didn't see it.
What kind of love makes you go out when the rain
is falling? That boy's screwing me. What are you doing? Thank you very much for doing that to me. I appreciate that shit. Start over again. Start it over again. Start over again. What kind of best I can give you, baby, as long as I give you. What kind of...
I'm sorry. Start this again. Either shut up or get out of here.
Bullshit. Start it up again. I need you to start it up again. Raise it up, please. Raise it up. I can't hear it in here. They say, you know what they say?
Yeah, what do they say?
They say Raid kills trolls dead. Yeah. Well, you know what I think? I think Raid does kill trolls dead. Yeah. Kevin, hold that for me, bro, if you would.
Right on.
Hold that. You see what I'm saying? I wonder what some Pepto-Bismol would look at this guy's face. How about that? He's all constipated. How about that? Yeah, buddy. As long as rub it in his face like that. All right, there you go. You know what I'm talking about? Raid kills trolls dead. As long there you go. Got that one? Ah, oh, there you go. Here's that clown from last week. Sean Brennan. Oh, I'm so special. I'm so special. I'm the biggest fool in the ball. Hey, buddy. How about a little something in your face there? Yeah. There you go.
I'm going to get the last laugh here. And I am the one that's going to be the one smiling at the outcome. Take it for whatever you want. You don't fuck with me. You don't fuck with me because I'm going to fuck with you. And I'm going to fuck with you so hard, I'm going to make you wish you were never fucking born. Trust me when I say that. Bank on that.
As long as I show you.
Kevin!
And give you, baby.
And this clown right here. Oh, God, this clown right here. Yeah, you're special, all right. Special Ed, how about that one? You want a little enema there? How about this? Troll. Hey, troll. Raid kills trolls dead. Hey, you know what? I got a little special something for you, love. You like that? You like a little bit of that mascara on your face? How about on your chin right there? You like that? How about a little like that?
He loves things.
And lastly, last but not least,
What kind
oh.
of
love? Pipsqueak. Ooh, pipsqueak. Woo! And you know what? If something doesn't go right, I'm the first one to say it's not going to go right. All right? But I knew what I know what I need to do and what we did and with that song. And that song was a song. No, I'm going to say that. That song was a great song. I know the words of that song. It was a great song. So we need to work together, guys. We need to work together. We have stuff that happens, but we need to work together. But when someone, you know, goes on their soapbox and continuously tries to harass people, we know about that. Okay, then that's pretty much what it comes down to. We take care of business. You don't like me, that's tough. I'm not here making a hate speech or doing hate speech, but when someone attacks my character and attacks my persona and puts a hate speech on me, it's going to come right back at you. And how do you like the heavy dose of that? Okay, yeah, things bomb. That song was a good song, and that song was, now I'm going to say it, was a song that was fine. When we have something goes on with these equipment, with the boards, the sound, you know, it's not perfect. That's why I really didn't want to do a show this year, because for 17 years, we've had to deal with this.
All right, folks. We do it till we do it right. We'll do it all night. All right, Kevin, seriously, man. Really? 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 Jesus Christ. Let's go to the bridge, and we'll be right back on The Gorgeous George Show.